Did you know that there's actually a whole bunch of tools out there for creating your own custom Windows ISOs? Some of these have nice interfaces, others are just command line based, and then you get those that create completely stripped down versions of Windows for you automatically. And did you also know that all of these tools basically use the same underlying methods to make changes to these Windows images? And that it's actually directly available in Windows? Well, today we're going to dive a little deeper on the subject. First, I'll explain how Windows image customization actually works, so you understand what's happening behind the scenes. Then, I'll show you the tools that make creating custom Windows ISOs really easy. And finally, I'll talk about community projects that have already done the work for you. Now, before we get started, I want to be clear that modifying Windows images can carry risks and potentially break Windows if you remove the wrong components. This video is for educational purposes, and I'm not telling you to use any specific software or tool. You should always test custom images in a virtual machine first, and make sure you understand what you're doing. Also, this video is not a tutorial on how to use any of these tools. If you'd like me to create tutorials on any of the tools I mention in this video, let me know in the comments down below. So let's start with the first point, how Windows image customization actually works. Understanding this will help you make better decisions about which tools to use and what to expect from them. And don't worry, I'm going to keep this simple and practical. So every Windows ISO file contains something called a Windows image file. That's either install.wim or install.esd in the sources folder. This is basically a compressed version of the entire Windows installation. Windows comes with a built-in tool called DISM that can mount this image to a folder, kind of like extracting a zip file. Once you mount the image with DISM, you can literally browse through all the Windows files. Delete stuff you don't want, add drivers, remove Windows features, and modify settings. When you're done, you can save the changes back to the image and then create a new ISO file. That's basically how all these Windows customization works under the hood. Now, there's another approach called answer files. Instead of changing the Windows image itself, you create an XML file that tells Windows how to configure itself during installation. This can skip setup screens, create user accounts, configure privacy settings, and even uninstall some of the software that's included in Windows. Now, as you can probably tell, doing all of this manually with command lines and XML files is pretty tedious. That's exactly why people in the community have created tools to make this process much easier. Which brings us to the second point, the tools that make creating custom Windows ISOs really easy. These tools basically give you a nice interface to do all the DISM and answer file stuff I just showed you, without having to remember complicated commands or write XML code. First up is NT Lite, which is probably the most user-friendly option. It gives you a clean interface where you can load a Windows image, remove components you don't want, add drivers and updates, configure settings, and create answer files. Behind the scenes, it's using the DISM commands I explained earlier, but you don't have to worry about that. What I really like about NT Lite is that it shows you exactly what each component does, so you know what's safe to remove. As we can see here, you can get rid of a ton of stuff in Windows. Now, the drawback is NT Lite is a paid tool. Although it has a free version, you won't have access to the more advanced features. Next is MSMG Toolkit, which is completely free but uses a text-based menu system instead of a graphical interface like NT Lite does. It's basically an organized collection of DISM commands that you can run through menu options. You can select your source, which is the Windows ISO file, and then you can integrate updates and drivers, remove components, and customize the Windows image with custom cursors, themes, and more. If you don't mind command line interfaces, this tool is incredibly powerful and supports the latest Windows versions. And then there's ET Optimizer, which is also completely free and primarily known as a Windows optimization tool. But it also has the ability to create custom ISOs with all its optimizations baked in. So you can create a Windows image that's already optimized for performance and privacy right from the start. Now, if you want to focus on the answer file approach, there's the Sneegan's Unattended Generator. And this is a web-based tool that lets you configure Windows settings through a nice interface. And then it generates the XML answer file for you. You don't modify the Windows image at all, you just tell Windows how to set itself up. This is actually the service I used to create the base answer file for my project called Unattended Winstall before I added my own customizations and optimizations to the XML file. Now, maybe you're thinking this still sounds like a lot of work. I just want a clean Windows installation without having to configure everything myself. Well, that's where the community projects come in, Which brings us to the third point, community projects that create customized versions of Windows. These are projects where developers have already done the customization work and created lightweight, optimized versions of Windows that you can just download and use. The trade-off is, though, that you're stuck with their choices. But if you just want a cleaner Windows experience, this might be perfect. What's great about these projects are that they're fully open source, so you can see exactly what's happening to the Windows image, if you understand how to read code. And even then, these days, you can just ask AI to explain the code to you. Now, first up is Tiny 11, which is a stripped down version of Windows 11 that can run on older hardware with just 2 gigs of RAM. The developer uses the methods I explained earlier to remove tons of unnecessary components and create a really lightweight Windows experience. On top of this, they also provide the PowerShell scripts so you can see exactly what they removed. Then there's MicroWin by Chris Titus, which is a part of his Windows utility tool. This creates a deep-loaded Windows image, and it can even inject drivers from your current system to ensure hardware compatibility when you reinstall Windows. But it's more of an automated tool rather than a pre-made image. But I really think MicroWin is one of the most stable custom Windows versions you'll get, and it's really easy to use. And then finally, there's my own project called Unattended Winstall, which focuses on the answer file approach. Instead of directly modifying the Windows image, it's a pre-made answer file that automatically configures Windows during the installation. It skips the forced Microsoft account during the setup and lets you create a local account, configures privacy and registry settings, and it also uninstalls a bunch of the pre-installed apps that come with stock versions of Windows. So which of these approaches should you actually use? Well, that comes down to your personal preference. If you just want a lightweight version of Windows without having to do the customizations yourself, the community projects like MicroWin, Tiny 11, and Unattended Winstall will be perfect for you. But if you want more control and you want to do the customizations yourself and you don't mind spending a little bit of money, then I think NT Lite is the best option. Otherwise, use MSMG Toolkit or the ET Optimizer. Just make sure that you test your custom Windows ISO file in a virtual machine or a test computer first to ensure that it is stable and that you didn't accidentally remove some needed components from the Windows image. But with all of that being said, if this video was of any value to you, please give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel, because it really helps out and it lets me know that you want more of this type of content. And if you want to watch some more videos about customizing Windows, check out the videos I link at the end here. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.